dog. Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, your channel, the station that you watch and experience. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis, and I'm taking you through Chemistry Form 2. Please do stay tuned throughout the lesson and pay attention. So, what are the goals of this lesson? By the end of this lesson, you'll have achieved the following. Number one, we'll describe the molecular structure of substances. We'll also be able to describe atomic structure, and we'll also state the properties of compounds with molecular and atomic structure. So molecular structure, compounds may range from, let's look at sugar, you also have iodine, fats and oils, paraffin wax. These atoms forming the molecules are held together by covalent bonds. The atoms in these compounds are held together by covalent bonds. Remember, we have introduced ourselves to covalent bonding, etc. So intermolecular forces. The molecules are held together in solid, liquid, or gaseous state in regular pattern by weak van der Waals forces, and the regular pattern repeats itself many times, resulting in the formation of molecular structure. For instance, iodine. The bond between two atoms of iodine is covalent bond. Don't forget, this is a member of halogen and it has got diatomic molecule. But now, the atoms, that is the molecules themselves, this molecule and this molecule, they are attracted to one another, and this results in a bond which we have referred to as the weak van der Waals forces. So the force between the molecules is weak van der Waals forces. Let's look at hydrogen bond, which is one of the bond in molecular substances. Considering water. Water is made up of three atoms. One atom of oxygen bonded covalently to two atoms of hydrogen. And oxygen has got high electronegativity, and therefore it attracts the bond electrons towards its end, making the end where we have oxygen to be partially negative. The hydrogens, on the other hand, since they are very far away from the bond electrons, they develop a partially positive charge. Now, the bond between the molecules, therefore, becomes a hydrogen bond. The force of attraction between the positively charged hydrogen and the negatively charged oxygen of another atom constitutes what we are referring to as what? A hydrogen bond, which is much more stronger than van der Waals forces. Let's look at the two, comparing ionic and molecular compounds. This table will help us get to into details. So let's look at the following property. State at room temperature, this is crystalline. Molecular substances are liquid, gas, or solid. Melting point is very high in ionic compounds. In molecular substances, it's very low due to the weak van der Waals forces. Electrical conductivity as a liquid. Ionic compounds, yes, they conduct in molten state because they have mobile ions, but molecular substances, they do not conduct. Solubility in water. Ionic compounds, most have high solubility, but molecular compounds, most of them have very low solubility in water, but basically they dissolve in organic solvents. Conduction of electricity when dissolved in water, yes. But molecular compounds, they do not dissolve. That is, they do not conduct, whether dissolved in water. Atomic structure, the likes of diamond and graphite. Diamond and graphite are allotropes of carbon. We refer to what are allotropes as we continue. But now let's look at diamond. Diamond, in diamond, carbon forms four uses all the four valency electrons, forming very strong covalent bonds, and this results into formation of an octahedral giant atomic structure. And for that reason, diamond does not have any delocalized electron. It is the hardest naturally occurring substance. On the other hand, graphite forms in graphite carbon bonds with three valency electrons. So one electron is left delocalized, and this results in the formation of hexagonal layers, which are held together by weak van der Waals forces. The weak van der Waals forces hold the layers together, and since the layers are held by weak van der Waals forces, they can strip over one another, and this makes it a lubricant, especially in parts which or where a lot of heat is generated, because they have got very high melting point. Don't forget that they have one delocalized electron, and therefore this makes graphite a good conductor of electricity. Now, did we get to understand some of the goals of this lesson? Let's try to answer the following question. State with the reason why diamond is used in making drill bits. Graphite is used in electrical conductivity. What is a hydrogen bond? Explain the difference between the boiling point of water and that of hydrogen sulfide, yet both of them are molecular substances. Refer to this book for more information, or most importantly, give us a text through the number on your screen, or visit our YouTube page at Erimu TV, as well as Facebook, or give us a tweet at erimutv_KE. So, once again, your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis. Pay attention for more lessons to come.